Good morning. Welcome to Veera's Voice. You would have seen that many high-profile personalities are being infected, starting from actors to ministers to Home Minister of India, Mr. Amit Shah, who is undergoing treatment. We pray for the speedy recovery of Mr. Amit Shah. When these people get affected, ministers, actors and all this, media is blowing it out of proportion and telling everywhere that news is being blown up. But one sector which has not been focused by the media is, as all you know, they are the unsung heroes of this COVID-19 service, and they are the bankers. Not only bankers, but even customers who are visiting the banks are being put at risk. These banks have become are becoming hotspots of COVID-19, and the standard operating protocol given by the SLBC or the state governments or the district administration are floated more than it is followed. There have been instances when we go to the banks, we see people who come unprotected. Bankers don't know whether these people are COVID positive or negative, because the testing is not ramped up, and they are put to direct risk with the customers. And the customers, they also don't know whether the bankers, anybody is having COVID-19, and they are will be affected by that. I visited a few branches and I found that people are accustomed to their old fashion of banking, especially in rural areas. I saw a customer outside a bank who was counting the currency using his saliva as a thing for counting the notes. This is the old practice, and removing his mask, he is using his saliva for counting the currency. I don't know whether he has withdrawn the money or he is going to deposit the money. If he is going to deposit the money, the risk for the bankers is, you know, what will happen. So there are more than 100 bankers across the country who have succumbed to this COVID-19, and some of the stories are very horrible. Senior level bankers, and people say that people with comorbidities are prone to a lot of risk. As a banker, everyone knows bank people are above the age of 35 or 40 are diabetic, hypertension, and if they don't have these two diseases, they are not eligible to be bankers. This is what is happening in the banking industry today. And customers, their need is they want to transact the business as usual, and the government has never stopped the banking industry. Even public transport has been stopped, airline has been stopped, hotels have been closed, many of the private hospitals have downed their shutters. Essential services, many of the essential services are not functioning, and there is a time limit for every service except for banking. And more pressure is mounting on the bankers as well as customers. This emergency credit line and as well as the Jandan account dispersal, it is building pressure, because now bankers are functioning only with 50% of the capacity as per the protocol. Many places they are not back to normal. But what RBI, Finance Ministry and bank management's need is that all bankers should be functioning normally under abnormal condition. This is a very risky proposition, and nobody is focusing on the risk faced by the, it is not the credit risk, it is the life risk of the bankers. They have been unsung heroes during this pandemic period, delivering the all essential services non-stop, even through ATMs, and whatever is there has been not been a single complaint that a bank has not served any of the customers. And the risk is for the customers also, especially in rural areas. They throng the branch, especially on pension day or this MNRGS payment or this other payments, government payments. Banks in rural areas, they are with minimal staff and they are unable to service. There should be a specific protocol, standard operating protocol for bankers, and customers should be made to follow this protocol. And we see that many of the policemen and police women are standing in the street curtailing the transport and other things, but they should be posted to bank branches which are vulnerable and where there is a lot of crowd. to regulate the crowd and see that social distancing and other things are being monitored. Especially in rural remote branches, the staff are not equipped with any protective gears. This increases the exposure, and many of the branches which are to be commuted now, because public transport is not there, the staff are finding it very difficult to reach the branches. But in spite of all difficulties, they use the personal vehicles and other things, and incur additional cost also. Now bankers have received an wage settlement, but more than the wage settlement, it is the life protection which is required now, for which the customers as well as the bankers should take up the issue with the appropriate authority, because there is nobody to speak about the risk faced by the bankers today. Anybody visiting, if you tell this outside, they will say there is a standard operating protocol. Anybody violating that should be punished. You come and see in any branch, whether in rural or semi-urban or even in many of the city branches, people throng the branch because their requirement is that their services should be fulfilled. And now people, foreigners, NRIs returning from abroad, they carry a very big risk. This quarantine, whether it is being followed strictly, people are not following that strictly, they visit branches, and the risk is multifold. Kindly share this with all your colleagues and customers, so that this reaches the people who are in power, so that the standard operating protocol for bankers is being revisited and proper instructions are given. Because if banking machinery collapses with a lot of infection, then the entire economy will collapse. It is not only the interest of the bankers, it is interest of the customers and the interest of the economy that corrective action should be taken at this time. Every day, people known, unknown, every banker is being infected, and many deaths are happening, which is very difficult to digest. So let us share this message with our colleagues and customers and our people's representatives, so that it reaches to the people and remedial actions are taken. Kindly subscribe to my channel and give any feedback on this issue, so that we can talk more on this issue. Thank you.